There is no doubt that in whatever we do in life, we are being closely watched by the people around us. Hence, how far we go is equally determined by how satisfied or otherwise they were with our performance in the first instance. In Akwa Ibom State, there is a well-known slogan which says, "One good term deserves another." This, understandably, has formed the basic principle for the return of His Excellency Chief Godswill Obot Akpabio, Executive Governor of Akwa Ibom State, to the revered Hilltop Mansion, the Governor's Lodge, which he himself built. The race to the Hilltop Mansion was exciting, but the feat achieved by the governor in his first term was too intimidating to be ignored even by his critics, culminating in landmark victory in the April 2011 governorship election, averaging over 90% of the total votes cast.
I will be faithful and bear true allegiance to the Federal Republic of Nigeria. And defend the Constitution of the Federal Republic of Nigeria. So help me God.
With over 211 new roads and flyovers, more than 3,000 life-touching projects, over 1,400 communities linked to the national grid, a completed brand new international airport, an introduction and implementation of the free and compulsory education policy alongside the free healthcare program for the aged and pregnant women and children, the stage was set for the return of the man whose preoccupation has always been to transform the state from a pedestrian to a destination state. And so, on May 29, 2011, Chief Akpabio commenced his second missionary journey, as it were, with his deputy, Mr. Nsima Ekere, to consolidate or take the nation's land of promise to another level of development. At a time when others proceeded on vacation shortly after the inauguration, for Governor Godswill Akpabio, it has been work, work and more work as he races against time to complete turnkey projects, even as he initiates others.
In the last 100 days, I will say that we have managed to complete a lot of projects which we initiated within the first tenure. And we completed and commissioned a brand new prisons for the Nigerian Prison Services. I was privileged to have the personal vice president of Nigeria representing Mr. President. And people tend to think that that prison, for instance, is a correctional prison. It's the first correctional prison with adequate facilities that will meet international standard in Nigeria. And for this, I give glory to God. The second aspect of it is that, yes, indeed, when we started, I did what I had always loved to do, which was handing over the state and the second tenure to God. And each time we have any security problem, I always tell people it would have been worse if we did not have God. And because I believe that God is the governor, and as usual, I remain the vice governor. So that aspect of it, on a monthly basis, we have also tried to call interdenominational service and hand over all our intentions to God Almighty. And so far, God has not let us down.
Shortly after assuming duties, And with the proclamation of the 5th Assembly on the 5th of June, the state governor led members of the new assembly and other officials of state to commission the newly constructed Ntarinyang Bridge, while also hosting Mr. President Dr. Goodluck Ebele Jonathan, ably represented by Vice President Namadi Sambo, on a working visit.
I'm commissioning this bridge for the youth by Akwa Ibom people and all Nigerians. I'm very, very grateful to God Almighty, and I'm doing this on behalf of the state government, on behalf of the House of Assembly members with their new speaker, Samikon, and all the leadership who are here, on behalf of the good people of Itu with their chairman of council, as well as the Paramahola and all traditional fathers of Itu. I'm saying that whoever passes this bridge shall not have accident. I'm saying that this bridge will bring progress, will bring economic relief, will bring economic prosperity, will be a showcase, and at the same time will improve the aesthetic value of Itu and Akwa Ibom State, and will in turn enhance the living standard of our people. And I do this commissioning in the name of God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Projects commissioned during the visit include the second phase of Ekiritami to Calabar Dual Carriage Way, the multi-billionaire pipe jacking underground drainage system initiated and completed by the Akpabio administration to contain the hitherto prevalent flood problem in the state. The facility, which is the first of its kind in Africa, has the capacity to generate electricity for the state.
I will join the good people of Akwa Ibom State to thank you very much and to continue with this good work. One good thing deserves another. So therefore, I'm seizing this singular opportunity to assure you that the federal government will continue to cooperate with you, will continue to support you, will continue to do everything to ensure that you succeed in this good venture. It is true that from what I am seeing here, it's like I'm going to heaven.
The state also demonstrated its commitment to security by playing host to this year's Nigeria Army Day celebration, with Vice President Namadi Sambo representing President Goodluck Jonathan at the colorful ceremony which showcased the nation's military prowess.
Nigerian Armed Forces, and indeed the Nigerian Army, has been at the forefront of nourishing and consolidating our democracy. It has remained committed to the protection of our democratic values as enshrined in the Constitution. I believe that Nigerian Army deserves every support at occasions such as this, when its cherished values and history are being celebrated.
With the ban in operations of commercial motorcycles to create a better means of transportation in the state, there has been an influx of motor vehicles, particularly in the capital city, bringing pressure on the existing roads, particularly the single-lane roads like Akanudo-Eket Road, where traffic holdups have become a regular feature. Aware of this problem and in a bid to address it, the governor signed a 28 billion naira contract with Julius Berger PLC for construction of a third ring road in Uyo, the capital city, complete with flyovers to help in taking off the pressure of traffic on Akanudo-Eket Road, which contracts for dualization had already been awarded to a Chinese firm.
This third ring road will be a 12 kilometer or 4 lanes for a start. Of course, that would mean equivalent of 2 lanes on this side, 2 on this side. But we are leaving spaces for eventual extension to 12 lanes on both sides, so for a start. But we want to see at least 4 lanes out of 12 kilometers, about there, which will really, because it's 4 lanes, that'll be like 24 kilometers or thereabouts. And we'll start from Rushen Obasanjo Road to Oran Road, and we'll pass by and through the Tropicana. We will have one number flyover at the Rushen Obasanjo Way, one number flyover. That is a new one, which is a further completion for our
students. This, of course, opens the door also into the future. From our side, we are very confident and we are extremely happy that the achievements from the past we can continue into the future, and that we also can play a role and be a stakeholder in the transformation of Akwa Ibom State. And for after also of Rio to become a world-class city.
Inviting you now to formally unveil the plaque that signals the commencement of the dualization of the Akan Nwodo Road. What you have seen there, in law we call it res ipsa loquitur, which means the act speaks for itself. That is going to be translated on the ground by no less a company than CCECC. It is with great pleasure this afternoon that we will do the groundbreaking of this important project. From what I have seen today, in Akwa Ibom, there is no doubt that the people of Akwa Ibom have good luck with them. I said they have good luck because God has used his wisdom to send God's will to deliver the democratic dividends to the people of Akwa Ibom, and I'm calling upon the people of Akwa Ibom to support transformation and continuity.
But perhaps the major thrust of the Akpabio administration this time around would be total industrialization of the state to create over 1 million job opportunities to the teeming youths in the state. As a first step, the governor has, for the first time in the history of the state, appointed a special advisor on industrialization and investment to prepare grounds for the industrial revolution being expected here. Add to this are plans to dualize all the entry points to the state to make movement in and out less chaotic. They include the Aba Ikodekpene Uyo Highway, Uyo Abak Road, Uyo Etinan Road, as well as Etinan Eket Highway.
The idea is to take traffic totally away from the town center. It's almost like you are surrounding Uyo. It's in line with the master plan of the city itself, you know, which had always been proposed but wasn't done. And it's almost like opening up the town to new areas, because as we are expanding, the population is increasing. You can imagine during the last census, during the last election, the number of people registered in Uyo to vote were about 170,000. And of course, that means that if you have 170,000 people registered to vote, that means the population with children will not be less than 400,000. And that is just when we did not see the kind of massive infrastructure rollout and the kind of development that we are doing now. So I expect that in the next 3 years, before the end of my tenure, the population of Uyo as a city would have doubled to 800,000. That's my prediction. And that means that there's going to be a lot of pressure on the existing infrastructure. So it's necessary, even as we are opening the third ring road, we are now opening up new areas for people to go and build houses, new areas for people to build facilities, and for people to have offices. So this is essential for the kind of thing I'm looking at. And then, of course, the totally diverse traffic from the town center, so that what we are doing is futuristic, so that we don't end up choking the urban center as the town progresses. And that's why we also had to do the flyovers. You know, you may think that at the moment that the city does not need so many flyovers, as I've already completed 3, I'm about to embark on 2 others, which, of course, God willing, in the next 2 years, I will complete them. I want to take Akwa Ibom people into heaven. That's why I'm giving them Dubai standard cinema plexes. So you walk in there to watch films and you think you are sitting down in Dubai. I'm taking Akwa Ibom to help them because the longest runway in the country today is in Akwa Ibom State. And we want to make sure everything we do is world-class standard. So when you are gliding on that runway, you think you are flying straight into heaven. I'm taking Akwa Ibom into heaven. That's why we are building the second five-star hotel. You stand on the 16th floor and you look down on the green fields of Uyo. And then you turn around and say, where am I? Not taking Akwa Ibom to the sky. I'm taking us straight into heaven. And I expect by 2015, with the infrastructural renaissance, we will arrive there in heaven. And Nigerians will come to see the small heaven in Nigeria. Call Akwa Ibom State.
Emphasis in this year is going to be continue to build world-class infrastructure for Akwa Ibom State, but also grow the economy by industrializing the state. His Excellency the Governor is committed to building 31 industries for Akwa Ibom people. We're looking at having at least one industry per local government area. Now, we believe that industrialization will grow our economy. It will take it will provide jobs for our teeming youths. It will take our children away from crime and give them sustainable and profitable economic activities for them to be engaged in.
He's a capable leader who has a clear-cut vision and that is focused. In 2007, in June, while many of the other governors who had just been elected were still grappling with issues such as appointments of cabinets and issues of budgets, issues of priorities, he already had his blueprint ready. And that was why it was not surprising that by August, we're already hitting the ground running. The major projects that we accomplished the first time between 2000 and 2011, the contracts were all awarded within the first 100 days when he took office. So that shows that he was adequately prepared. It was not a question of thinking about what to do after you have been elected as governor.
It has been a period of the continuation of the common transformation agenda of His Excellency Governor Godswill Obot for the people of Akwa Ibom State. It has been a period of a continuation of the free and compulsory education program, continuation and sustenance of the free healthcare program for children, pregnant women, and the aged. A period of continuation of the massive infrastructural development, road construction, and what have you. It's also a period that is seen to be the initiation of a major investment in industrialization. It's a period where the framework for the true industrialization of Akwa Ibom State has been conceptualized and put in place, and in a matter of time, Akwa Ibom will be an industrial engine of Nigeria, and our people, our teeming youth, will have opportunity of being employed, and that will transform the socio-economic landscape of the state and provide a new milestone for the state.
It's already awarding contracts. You know, you're aware of the Third Ring Road contract award. That's about 28 billion. We have opened the contract or tender for the contract for Uyo Ikore Mineral Road, and as well as other roads being considered. He has told the people of Akwa Ibom State that he's going to is working on awarding the contract of Uyo Itinan Eket Road. These are strong development strides for Akwa Ibom State, which he has already embarked on.
I am 75 years old now, so I can say I have lived to see so many governments, and especially the creation of Akwa Ibom State. I don't think we've ever seen any governor that has been able to perform like this particular governor. The transformation that is happening in this state, we have never witnessed in our life. I mean, I couldn't believe that within 3 years, because in fact, most of these things happen within 3 years. Within 3 years, this man could have transformed this state into what it is. Everybody knows I'm a well-traveled Nigerian, and I've gone to all parts of Nigeria, not to talk of the world. But I don't know of any state that has been able to do what this governor has done within 3 years. And I'm one of those who, those of you who know me, I don't say things that I don't believe in. I mean, I've traversed all parts of the states. And one of the good things about this governor is that it's not only in Uyo that you see him. You see him in all parts of the state. For those of us who are clergymen, we are praying for him. All those who, because of reasons best known to them, they do what they are doing, we ask God to forgive them. But, you know, God's forgiveness cannot last forever. And so if there is punishment to the third and fourth generation to those who are doing it, that's a headache.
Akpabio has become a destination for me. Sometimes when it gets very hectic in Lagos, I end up in Akwa Ibom. I go to the Ibom Hotel and wow. Yeah, just wonderful. It's a measure of the development that Akpabio has seen since the last 3 or 4 years. Akpabio has just been phenomenal. It's simply incredible. I've had the opportunity of talking to him, and what amazes me is the passion that he exhibits. When you're talking to him, you find a man who is driven, I'm talking about driven, to change not just the physical structures, the infrastructure of the state, but the psyche of the average Akwa Ibom person. And it's working. Because I tell you, the Akwa Ibom that I knew 3 years ago, for instance, is different Akwa Ibom. You know, the people are confident. I mean, the roads, I mean, it's just amazing. Even if
The Godswill Obot Akpabio administration in Akwa Ibom State in the last 4 years, spanning May 29, 2007 till May 29, 2011, is in the words of the average Akwa Ibom person, transformational. I have been coming to Akwa Ibom State from 2002, when he became the commissioner in the state. And up to the end of the last administration, the administration that preceded his own. And what I've seen from when he took over to the end of his administration, before he now came into the second tenure, is totally phenomenal. In terms of road infrastructure, in terms of human capital development, in terms of social engineering, in terms of positioning, conscious positioning of his people and his state, you know, to take their right place in the Committee of States of Nigeria. You see an incredible commitment to leadership, and that's the much I can say. And I'm very proud of Godswill Obot Akpabio. Nigerian youths are indeed very proud of him. He has shown that the younger generation of Nigerians are committed to development of Nigeria. And I do challenge every Nigerian that goes to America and says, America, America, Britain, Britain, somebody built Britain, somebody built America. So what I see in Godswill Obot Akpabio is a leader that is committed to building a new Nigeria in his state.
Never has Akwa Ibom State witnessed such transformation. With the pace we are going, the state no doubt is bound to overtake older states and set a benchmark that would be absolutely difficult to surpass.